Ida, I'm happy to help out.
No, no, thanks, Mac, but I don't want to turn it into a big thing with Sadie's dad.
And you always seemed like such a nice guy.
Yeah, I guess you don't know somebody until you start dating their daughter.
Poor Sadie. She must be so embarrassed.
It's just different. You know, dating someone who still lives at home. What more complicated than I first thought?
Guess you're used to dating women on the other end of the age spectrum.
Get off it, Mac. Richmond's hardly a grandmother.
Yeah, and Sadie's not a baby either.
Yeah, but she still lives at home.
Hello, anybody home?
Yeah, we're in here. Okay. I've told Dad he was way out of line, and this is for you. For the new tyres.
I really can't take your money, Sadie.
Mum covered up anyway. She feels just as embarrassed as I do.
I really appreciate it, but it's my problem.
You know this only happened because you're seeing me. I'm going to leave you guys to it. Okay. Will you please accept it? I feel so bad.
It's fine. Okay, really. But it has got me thinking. You know, your parents are obviously struggling with, you know, you seeing me.
They'll get used to it.
Will they, though? I mean, you and me. It just all happened really fast. And I know, I think maybe we need a time out. Give us a chance to catch our breath.
You want to break up with me?
It's a lot going on right now.
Sure. Because who wants to risk dating the overprotective cop's daughter, right? Who wants that hassle? Way more trouble than it's worth.
That's not what I meant.
Byron, I'm not stupid.